In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to design a business card like this. And this is coming up. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel once again. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So here are the resources that I'm going to use, especially the social media handles and all the icons. I'll leave a link to download them in the description. Be sure to check it out. And without any further ado, let's jump right into Photoshop. So here in the magic world of Photoshop, the first thing that you do is you go to file and then you select new. And then we're going to create a document for business card. The standard document for business card is in inches, 3.5 by 2. So 3.5 for the width over here and then 2 for the height. Now you can keep the resolution at 300 or 600. You see the image size is very small, so you can even increase this one to 600 because we're not actually printing this one. But then if you are printing, you can basically use the 300 resolution. Now you go ahead and then you click OK, and then you should have something like this. We're going to use a very simple color for this one. Actually, this is the actual logo, but then it has been represented on a 3D mockup as well, so it looks good on the 3D. Let's try to use the 3D. But then if you are actually designing this for a client, you might want to use their original logo. Okay, so we're going to do this in two folds, the front and then the back. So we're going to do the front right away. You go ahead and then you select the solid color over here, and then you're going to give it a color. Actually, we're going to use the color from the logo, so let me just click OK here. Go to the resources and bring the logo in. Let's use this particular one. So let me drag and drop this inside over here, and then I'm going to press Ctrl T to transform it out. I hold Shift and then Alt to transform it out like this, and I'm going to leave it over here. So I'm going to pick the color from the logo over here. I'm going to pick it from the surroundings. Let me zoom in like that, and then you realize that when I double click over the color field, like pick a color, I can actually use the eyedropper over here to select a color from this one. So let's go for something like this, way darker. Or what do you think? Let me know which of the colors you want. So I'm going to use this particular color just for illustration purpose, and then I'll go ahead and then I'll click OK. Now let me zoom back. You can actually do this by holding Z and then Alt, and then you can just be zooming in and out with the left click and then the right click. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to push this up here. Remember, this is serving as the cover, so it has to be very simple and minimalistic. Now, next thing, I'm going to choose my rectangle over here, create a very simple rectangle like this. And then I'm going to double click on this one to change the color to white. So I'll click OK from here, and then I can push this one over. This is going to be very simple and minimalistic. Next off, I'll go to the view over here, create a new guide, and I'm going to set it vertical 30%. So I'll click OK, and then I'll go to the view again, new guide, and I'm going to set 70% right over there. So it is going to give me these guides, and then I'll duplicate my rectangle by pressing Ctrl J, and then I'm going to change the color. So let me move it up a little bit like this, and then I'm going to change the color. So let me pick another color from the logo. I'm basically using the colors from the logo. Okay, so something like this, or yeah, I think this would do. Or let's make it a bit more yellow, something like that. And then I'm going to move this underneath of the rectangle here. I'll hold Alt and then move this one to this side to make sure that it is on the line with the guide that we created, so you can actually zoom in to check that one out. Now you use the arrow keys to push this one down a little bit like this, so that will be around here. You press Ctrl J, and then you can make a duplicate, and then you drag this one also over it. I believe by now you understand the reason why we created the guides over there. To get rid of it, you can easily press Ctrl H to hide it, so that you can actually see what you have for this one. Let me try to change my costume background right here, or to something medium gray, so that you can see the design that we're actually doing, because it's almost like blending with the background. Now the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to push this one up a little bit like this, and then we're going to write the names and then the slogan under it. So if you come over here, I've got the name, So prime trend, I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going on top over here, choose my test tool, which is T for the shortcut, and I'm going to paste it. So I'll press Ctrl A, select it all, and then I'm going to drag this to the right side to open it up like that. I'm going to change the font to a font called Railway, and I'm going to reduce this one to semi-bold. Now let me change the color to white over here so that you can see it very clearly. I go to the toggle character, and then I'm going to set the tracking to -40 so that it will be a bit close. I press Ctrl T from there, and then I'm going to transform it like this, and then I'll bring it over here. Press Ctrl A, and then I can set it to be right in the middle. So I press Ctrl T again to reduce it a little bit, and then I can push it up over here. I'll go ahead and then I'll press Ctrl J to duplicate that, drag it right beneath of it, and then I'll go and select my everything fashion over here. So prime trend is all about fashion, so you can check them out. I'll leave links to follow them in the description. So I select all of this one, press Ctrl V, and then I'm going to change this one to something way more smaller, so medium, and I'll press Ctrl T to transform this one out also like this. So I'll push it up over here, and then I'll change that particular color to the one that we used over here. So you click OK, and then OK, and then when you zoom in, you realize that you're having something simple like this. So now this can serve as our main or our cover, whatever you want to call it. So I'm going to select right from the everything over here straight to the prime trends logo, and I'm going to group that, and I can call that front. Once you're done with that, we're about starting creating the back, which is the most important part because it's going to contain all the information, the necessary information that someone can reach out to. So here is where you put out your best creativity if you want to grab the attention of the people. But then, you know, I'm a minimalist, so you're going to make this very minimal and very simple but very good looking. So we're not getting rid of the solid color over here, but then we're going to start off with a rectangle. So you create a rectangle. Perhaps you can actually first set a guide to guide you, say you make it 40% over here. Let's say 40%. And then you realize that this is the 40% one, right? We can just get rid of the first ones that we already set. So you pick your move tool, and then you can get rid of this one and that one. So you're going to create the rectangle to this side. So let me zoom out. And then let me draw my rectangle right to this side. If it's small, you can still expand it, okay? So I'm just going to double click over here to change the color to white. And then I click OK. Now I don't want any distractions, so I press Ctrl H to get rid of my guideline. As simple as that. We are going to bring in the logo again. So let me just go and bring in the logo again to this side. And then I'm going to hold Shift and then Alt to transform this one. So I'll place it right over here. Okay, next off, we're going to add a text to this one. So basically we're going to rewrite everything, but you can as well leave the logo like this, especially one that has already kind of like the name on it already. So this is kind of prime trends, so you can basically make that one big and then you leave it over there. Or if you have a team, that is one you can give them names and then they have various portfolios over there. So let's just assume that we are using the name and then the slogan again. Okay, so right over here we're going to have the prime trends again. So let's just copy this one and paste it, and I'm going to reduce the size like that, bring it right over here. I'm just using the color, the background color, this one, and I'll click OK, and then OK. I'm going to duplicate it again by pressing Ctrl J, and then I'll drag it over here. I'm going to select the everything fashion again, and I'm going to pick the text, select it all, and paste it. So I'll press Ctrl T to transform it out. Very simple, like that. Now you can select the two of them by holding Ctrl, and then you can press Ctrl T to transform all of them again. So like I was saying, if your team or your work has a couple of, or is made up of a team, you can just use a innocent Boateng graphics designer. Simple as that. Now you can select all of these three, and then you can bring them down here a little bit, or perhaps you can group them. Press Ctrl G to group them, press Ctrl A to select it all, and then you can actually align it vertical centers. So you press Ctrl D to deselect, and then we move to the next part, which is the mind-blowing part. So you remember we have a rectangle over here. Beneath the rectangle, we want to create a rounded rectangle. So we go beneath the rectangle and then you choose the rounded rectangle over here. Now the rounded rectangle, the radius will determine how curved it will be. So you realize that I have this one right over here. Now if I go ahead to change the radius to about 500, you realize that if I draw like this, it's give me a different curve altogether. So the radius is going to determine how the curve is going to look like. Now let me delete this, change this one back to 100. So I'm going to draw a rounded rectangle, something very simple like this one. Remember, it's beneath the rectangle, the first white rectangle that we created, so you can't really see it. I'm going to double click on this one to change the color. We are using the main color now. Now let's shift up a little bit to the top over here so that we can get something bright to complement this particular background. You move ahead and then you click OK, and then you can press Ctrl A, and then you align it at the vertical center so that it will be right in the middle. Now you hold Shift and then you can drag it to this side. Very simple and beautiful like that. Once you are done with that, you can then go ahead and then you add in the icon. So the first one is going to be the call icon. So I'll drag and drop it inside of Photoshop, and then I'll press or hold Alt and then Shift to drag it. Very simple like that. Hit on Enter and then I can place it somewhere around here. You right click on it and then you go to the blending options, and then you're going to give it a color. So the color white over here to make it pop out, and then you click OK and then OK from here. So you're going to add the second one, which is going to be the WhatsApp logo right over there. Remember, I'll leave a link to download all of these ones in the description. So I'm going to drag my WhatsApp icon also over here, and I'm going to hold Alt and then Shift to drag it close. Now here is a trick that you can actually use. You can basically set your rulers. Let me zoom in some more for you to see. You can set a couple of the rulers over here so that you make sure that they are almost all on the same line. So you grab your WhatsApp icon, you press Ctrl T, and then you transform it to fit the exact size that you set. In this way, you make sure that they are all on the same line. Alignment is very important when you're designing. So I'm just holding Shift and then dragging this down here a little bit. I think the latest version of Photoshop has that feature for you to evenly distribute or space out something like this. I think so. Let me know if you are using 2019 or 2020 and you have this feature. So the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to hold Alt and then you select the effect here, drag it onto the WhatsApp logo, and then you should have it also like that. Now you go into your resource again and then you do the same thing for the next one, which is the email. You drag it into Photoshop, but this one, it has a background, so you go for the magic wand tool, left click and it selects it all, hit delete, and then you press Ctrl D to deselect it, right click, and then you convert it to a smart object. Now go and choose your move tool and move this to the documents that you're working on in. You press Ctrl T and from there you can transform it to fit the exact size or the exact space you've created for this one. So something like this should be, and then you can push it up a little bit like that. Hold Alt and then you drag the effect onto this one. So I'm going to do the same thing for the last one, which is going to be the social media handle over here. I've got a couple of packs, so I'm just going to select only one, that is the Instagram one. Press Ctrl J to duplicate that, drag it into the logo or the business card that we are working on, and then you can press Ctrl T to open it up like this. So something like that, and then you can drag the effect onto it also. Once you have it like this, like I said, you can take your time to make sure that you've distributed this evenly. Let me just push this one up a little bit, and then you can select the four, press Ctrl J. If it looks so big for you, you can transform it. I think this looks good. What do you think? From there, we can just move ahead and then we add our text. So let me just get rid of these ones because we don't really need them anymore. All right, so let me just open it up and I'm going to select the text over here. I'm going to use the font Poppins. So I left click over here and then I can start putting in my text. So let me just go and copy the first one, which is the number and I'm going to paste it right over here. I'll select it all and decrease the size way smaller, like that, very small. So you can bring it over here, press Ctrl J, and then you make sure. Now you can still use the rulers over here to make sure that they are also in alignment. So you can bring your rulers like that, as simple as that, and you realize that this text is quite okay, but let's make it a bit smaller because we use it for the email and all those stuff as well. Lucky for us, the number and then the WhatsApp number are the same. So you press Ctrl J and then you can drag it down here to make sure that it is also set. Please be sure to follow PrimeTrends_GH on Instagram for all your fashion needs. You can press Ctrl A to make sure that all the rulers are gone if it is serving as a distraction for you. And you can select all your tests and then you group them. Basically, for every one of them, you can just give them a name, say test right over here. And you can group these ones as well by pressing Ctrl G, and then you can name this one icons. So you realize that when you turn this one off, that is what you're having. The last thing that we're going to do is we're going to create another rectangle over here at the very tip of it, and then we're going to change the color to a fine color, something like this, that will blend with whatever that we are doing. So finally, you can select from the rounded rectangle over here straight to the group one. You group that total one and then you call it the back or inside or however you want to call it. And then you realize that when you turn this one off, you can have your front and then your back right over here. So that'll be it. That's how you create a very simple and minimal business card for your business. Once again, a very big thank you to PrimeTrends_GH for allowing us to use their information on this particular card. Be sure to follow them up on Instagram at PrimeTrends_GH for all your fashion needs. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and don't forget to check out other tutorials and business cards that I've designed. I'll leave a link in the description to check them all out, and I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.